Peanuts Engineering, I'm Alan. In today's video we're doing some work on the lathe. We're making this spring-loaded plunger, which is a tap guide. This side will fit into your tailstock or a collet holder in your milling machine, and then this side goes into the back of a tap if it's got the centre drill hole. If it's not, you turn the plunger around and you have a counter bore on there which will fit the taps with the point on the back. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it. Today we're making a tap guide, which is a spring-loaded centre that's fitted in the spindle of a milling machine
or a chuck in the lathe tailstock.
It consists of a piece of steel, this is 10mm diameter silver steel, with a 60 degree point on one end and a centre drilled bore on the other end. It's about 40mm long. To go with that you'll need a spring. Now this spring is the type you get in these dispensers. There are different size springs, different diameters, and this one is one of the larger springs that you get out of a dispenser. It has a flat end on each side and about a 8mm bore. So the first thing I want to do today is change the chuck for a collet. Put a piece of wood on the bed just in case you drop the chuck, it won't damage the bed. This is my collet holder, it's a number 3 Morse taper. Fit the piece of steel in the collet. And the tool post, I just hold this dial indicator, which is on a block. Just because you're holding the part in a collet, it doesn't always mean they're running absolutely true. Normally this runs out a couple of thou, so let's have a look. Each division here is a tenth of a thou. You just turn the spindle round. That's running out 9/10 of a thou.
I've adjusted the compound slide to 30 degrees.
And what I want to do is face the end off and put a 60 degree angle on. Now I want to turn a parallel portion down so that this will fit on and butt up against a square face. This end's finished, so now I'll turn it round the other way, put it back in the collet and machine the other end. That's nearly finished now except for the flat I need to mill on. This is the spring and it just hooks over the edge. So that's done. So next we need to machine the body of the part. I fitted the three jaw chuck back on the lathe and that's holding a piece of 15mm silver steel. And this will make the body of the tap support. So first of all, we need to face this off and machine an 8mm hole through the bar down to about 40mm deep. This is a 9.5mm drill. Now I've swapped to the boring bar, and just to check that the boring bar is parallel with the bore, just do it by eye using the outside of the bar that you're going to machine. We need to check the depth that we need to go to. There, just set my DRO to zero for the depth. Just checking the bore size. .08. That'll do. I've pulled the bar out of the chuck slightly. Now I've placed the body in the three jaw chuck and I fitted my parting tool in the tool holder, set the tool square. I've measured the depth of the hole, just marked it in a black felt tip pen. From there, I've measured the length of a collet, and I want to part it off so that that much is sticking out of the collet when it's finished. So that length, total length on this is just under 80 millimetres. Just slow the speed down a bit. Well, I'm sorry to say that the next few minutes I didn't get because my memory card was full, but I did part the bar off. I've taken the parting off piece, turned it round and put it back in the chuck. And now I'm turning this diameter down to 12 millimetres to hold in a collet. Just remove the edge on this corner. All that remains now on this is to drill and tap a hole in the side. Today we've made the body of the tap guide and the plunger, which has 60 degree point and a centre hole in the end. And that's so if you have a tap with the centre in it, you can use the pointed end to locate your tap. Or if you have a tap that has that type of finish on it, a point, you can use the dome end to locate the tap. And all you have to do is just turn it round whichever side you need on the holder. So next week we'll be finishing the holder and the plunger. Well, that's it for today. We'll finish this off in part two. Thanks for watching, hope it was useful, and we'll see you next time on Enoch's Engineering.